So this exact one that I have with me here today is a mid-2012 MacBook Pro with i5 CPU. The RAM has been upgraded to 16 gigabytes of G-Skill RAM, and the SSD has been upgraded to a Western Digital Blue 500 gigabyte SSD. Now this computer is running OS Monterey unsupported using OpenCore Legacy Patcher. I'll put the link down in the description to show you guys the video on how it's installed. Version 4.11, and I mean it's pretty smooth, pretty stable so far. Let's open up Google Chrome. First thing we're going to test out is the internet, speed, responsiveness. Let's just type in random searches, let's go cooking. Comes up pretty fast. Let's go houses. Whoops. Definitely fast. Technology. Let's head over to YouTube. Opens pretty quick. We are streaming 1080p at 60 frames per second. Let's maximize the video. Minimize. This is a great way to test out the internal graphics of any laptop. Stream 1080p or 4K and minimize and maximize while the video is playing. I mean, I see a slight bit of lag in the transition from full screen to regular, but I mean, nothing crazy otherwise. Looks like it's playing pretty good. Jumps to unloaded parts of the video pretty quick. Decent for a 10-year-old computer, that's for sure. So now we're just gonna perform a boot test from power button to ready desktop. I mean, for a 10-year-old computer with an unsupported version of macOS 12.6, it's decent. The sound is actually pretty decent on this computer. Now let's just do a quick test to see how fast commonly used apps like Microsoft Word will open up. Pretty quick. Actually, very quick. Let's go for Excel. Definitely a reasonable speed. Let's try PowerPoint. A little slower on PowerPoint, but still reasonable. Final test is how quick this computer can go to sleep and recover from sleep. So we're just gonna wait until the light right here becomes blinky. And as soon as it does, we know the computer is fully asleep. Okay, it's asleep now. Let's see how quick it can recover. Decent. So all in all, is this 2012 MacBook Pro still relevant, still usable, and still good in 2022? I think it definitely is. For the majority of users that'll be using word processing, online internet access, it can definitely hold its own for a 10-year-old computer with upgraded SSD and RAM, of course. Hope you guys found value. Hit that like and subscribe button and stay tuned for more tech-related content to come in the future. Appreciate all the support always. Stay safe out there, guys.